Today, we're gonna be doing a super cool DIY. I'm gonna show you guys how to take a shirt apart, put it back together with a different pattern. That way you guys have the pattern and you can just make your own shirts going forward, because why pay like $50 or $60 at Zara or Topshop or H&M or ASOS when you could just be making your own, buying the fabric, and also just like feel super cool to be making your own clothing. So I'm gonna break it down for you probably as simply as I can. I'm happy to answer any questions you might have in the comment section. Also, if you like this video, subscribe, comment, do all the things. I will love you forever for it. Now, let's get into it. The shirt I'm going to be using today to make the pattern is this shirt from Top Man, and this shirt is kind of infamous. It definitely had a moment a few summers ago. I bought it and loved the shirt, and then all of a sudden, before I knew it, everyone else on the planet was also wearing the shirt. So it sat in the back of my closet with no love, and I figured it was the perfect shirt to use as an example. You can also do this without taking the shirt apart entirely, but we're going to take this shirt apart today because one, I'll never wear it again, and I also want to have an actual physical pattern that is exact so that I can show you guys how it works. One of the most important tools in sewing, and also my most dreaded tool to use, is the seam ripper, and what we're going to do today is use this to take the seams apart. I'm going to start by taking all the buttons apart and just getting it right underneath of the button where the threads are, so we don't rip the shirt and we just get the threads. The next step is to start working on the neckband, which is what holds the collar in place, and also the front plackets, which are where the buttons are on the front of the shirt. Those are the pieces that kind of hold the rest of the shirt together, and once you have those undone, the rest of the shirt should come apart pretty easily. All of these shirts are serged in the edges to keep them from fraying, so we are going to be picking this out. It is very tempting to cut it, but don't, because you want to know what that seam allowance was. It is also important to note that when they serge these, there is a little blade that cuts the edge of the fabric and then it wraps it with thread. So we do have to account a little bit for the part that's been cut off already when we're doing our seam allowances, but we can get into that here in a little bit. Now that I've got the shirt taken apart, I'm just going to press all of these pieces flat and beautiful. Also, if you are getting confused on where your pieces are going and you don't want to lose track of that, now would be a good time to label them just right on top of them, especially if you don't plan on putting the shirt back together and just using this as a pattern. For my new shirt, I'm using this black Georgette sheer fabric. I think it's going to be lightweight and super cool. I spent maybe $18 on the fabric. And now it's time to do our cutting. I like to weigh my patterns down with crystals. I use them as weights. You can also use straight pins. Just make sure not to mess up the fabric while you're doing it. If you notice when taking your shirt apart that there was a stiffener inside of the collar and on the front placket, it's a stabilizer or an interfacing. This one's fusible, so I'm going to go ahead and cut those out in the same shapes as the collar and for the front plackets. And because it's fusible, you can use an iron and just press them right to the fabric and they fuse beautifully. These stabilizers are used to help things hold shape. That's why they're used in collars and cuffs and all of those good things. Now that we've cut out all the pieces, it's time to start assembling. I always like to start with the back, and I start by sewing the top yoke onto the bottom part of the back. Before we actually start stitching, it's important to decide what your seam allowance is going to be. I saw that there was about a quarter of an inch seam allowance left over from where the old serge was, so I'm just going to follow that same amount and do a quarter of an inch when I'm stitching. This should still be enough for me to go ahead and serge the edges again and get a really good finish. After we've stitched, we are going to press that fabric flat and beautiful again. We are going to do a lot of pressing in this video, so if that's your favorite part, brace yourself, you're in for a good ride. After I have pressed everything open, I do like to go ahead and overlock the edges. I'm just going to follow suit of the previous shirt, but sometimes I do a French seam, but this does not have enough seam allowance, so we are just going to overlock this. And now let's attach the back panel to the front panels right at those shoulder seams. This is going to start giving the shirt the base to be able to be assembled now. After stitching the shoulders and you open it up, it should look something like this, and this is where our sleeve is going to go. We are just going to stitch right along this curve and make sure everything is pinned in so you know exactly where it's going to go and it doesn't fight you the entire way, although sometimes these slippery fabrics can get the best of you. After we have stitched the top cap of the sleeve all the way around that curve, I am going to overlock those edges and press that as well. And the next step will be to sew from the bottom all the way down the side seam. This is also going to kind of complete the shirt as far as like what the actual silhouette is going to be, and the rest of it is just finishing details. Next up is the collar, and we are going to sew those two pieces to each other. After we have stitched that together, it's time to turn it inside out, and then we're going to press those corners out so they're super sharp. I'm using the ends of a paintbrush, it's just what I have nearby me. Also, I'm going to press that super flat. It's also going to feel crispy because we have that stabilizer in there, and that's really what makes a collar feel like a collar and hold its shape. And now that that's finished, we can sew that into the neck band, which is what attaches it to the shirt. This also gives the collar a little bit of a lift and like away from your neck and your shoulders. It just kind of helps fit it around the neck beautifully. And you're going to pin that inside of the two neck band pieces and then do one stitch all the way around the neck band so that you have the shape. Now that we've stitched that, we're going to flip it inside out and then give it a good press so that it's ready to sew onto the neck part of the shirt after we do the plackets. Before we jump into the plackets, let's do a little bit of that interfacing on the front. I'm just using like an inch and a half piece of it all the way down. It's going to help hold the shape, and it's also going to help stabilize it when I do my snaps. I'm just going to fold over my piece twice like the original shirt. I did do a marking on the shirt to kind of help guide me there, and then I'm going to do a top stitch here all along the front. And now that we have the front plackets done, we can start to stitch in the neckline here. This is where our neckband with our collar is going to go. I'm just going to start pinning that into place so that I can start stitching that in. I think this is the trickiest part of the entire process, if I'm honest with you, so I make sure to use a lot of pins and really take my time. After it's pinned, we're going to sew that down, and then afterwards, I like to press everything really flat so that you can see how good of a job you did. It's also time for us to start doing the other side of it. So once we flip that shirt over, I can start to fold it, and you can get it lined up really closely with the stitch line. I press it so that it stays exactly where I want, and then I add more pins in. The last part of this step is to top stitch the entire thing, which really just finalizes it and makes it feel really professional. Rather than doing a button on the shirt, I'm going to do a Western snap because I think it's more fitting for the shirt. My personal style also has a Western kick to it, so it makes more sense. The last thing you'll want to do is hem the bottom of the shirt as well as the sleeves, and there you have it, your brand new custom shirt. I always like to make my own clothing. I think it feels so much more special. You know it's a one of a kind, and you've invested that time back into yourself and your craft. Please remember that practice makes perfect. Nobody gets it right the first time. It's totally okay to mess up. I think that the best learning lessons come from the mistakes. I am a self-taught designer, so I've been doing this for a long time and I still make mistakes. I still learn on every bit of the process. So I think it's really important to be kind to yourself and to allow yourself to like really explore what it's like to like move through a process. When it comes to storing the pattern pieces from the shirt that we took apart today, I like to label all of them, whether it's on a post-it note or I write on the actual pattern piece. If it is a post-it note, I would safety pin it to the actual pattern piece, but fold them all up, put them in a plastic bag, label on the outside of what the plastic bag is, or you could hang them over a hanger and put a little clamp on them. But you are going to want to make sure that you can keep your pattern pieces separate, so that way you know what they are. If you do this with a lot of different patterns or a lot of different pieces of clothing, you are going to want to make sure that you can find what you need when you're looking for it. And the best way to make sure that you can do that is to make sure that you are as organized and precise as possible. If you are a sewer or a home sewer, or you're wanting to get into it, you know the difficulties of having a million things floating around your studio. So do this little thing for yourself and you will set yourself up for success in the future. Just remember that this is your jumping off point. It will only get better from here. And this creative project is going to lead to 1,000 others. So until my next video, happy DIYing, and I'll chat to you soon.